السلام عليكم. My paper today will be about the evidence-based clinical practice guideline on antibiotic use for the urgent management of bulbal and periapical related dental pain and intraoral swelling. This paper done by Peter Lockhart and his group and published in JADA 2019. The purpose of this guideline is to assist clinicians and patients in determining the appropriate use of systemic antibiotic for the urgent management of the following target conditions: systematic irreversible bulbitis with or without symptomatic apical periodontitis, bulb necrosis with symptomatic apical periodontitis, and bulb necrosis and localized acute apical abscess with or without access to immediate definitive conservative tooth preserving dental treatment, which is bulbotomy, pulpectomy, non-surgical root canal treatment, or incision and drainage. They summarize the recommendations for a prescription of an antibiotic in this schedule, and they also summarize it in this figure. The first question: that does the patient have a pain or swelling? If pain only, we have to check the vitality of the bulb. If the bulb is vital and diagnosed with symptomatic irreversible bulbitis with or without symptomatic apical periodontitis, or even if it's diagnosed as a bulb necrosis and with a symptomatic apical periodontitis, so there is no need to prescribe an antibiotic, and we have to refer the patient to receive a definitive and conservative dental treatment. If a patient has a pain and swelling, and we diagnose has a bulb necrosis and localized acute apical abscess with or without systemic involvement, we have to prescribe an antibiotic, and we have to refer the patient to receive a definitive conservative dental treatment. And about the prescription of an antibiotic, we have to check the allergy of the patient to penicillin. If no, we have to prescribe an oral amoxicillin 500 milligram 3 times per day, 3 to 7 days. If not feasible, we have to prescribe an oral penicillin B potassium. If the first line treatment fails, broader antibiotic therapy to complement with the oral metronidazole, or discontinue first line treatment and prescribe oral amoxicillin and the clavulanate. If a patient has allergy to penicillin, we have to ask a patient if he or she have a history of anaphylaxis, angioedema, or hives with penicillin, ampicillin, or amoxicillin. If yes, so we have to prescribe an oral azithromycin or oral clindamycin. If no, we have to prescribe an oral cefalexin 500 milligrams 4 times per day from 3 to 7 days. If the first line of treatment fails, proton antibiotic therapy to complement with oral metronidazole. And thank you.